She sacrificed that money for white. Lil Fan got 3 rings, that's brum brum. We up one. Bad, dear savage. Take her to the mall and buy her some. That's gonna wanna make your friends come. Make way with the timing.
Why can't y'all recognize that we all came from sacrifice? Why can't y'all recognize that we all came from sacrifice?
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's game features arguably the best defense in the NFL. The Vikings are the least scored on team in the league, and they'll be up against a Ravens offense that will need to rise to the occasion. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, it's one of the new jewels of the NFL, no doubt, as you get a look inside U.S. Bank Stadium here in Minneapolis. The scene a short time ago, this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with the Baltimore Ravens. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you look at this Vikings ball club. They come in playing pretty good football, winners of 4 of their last 6 games. Meanwhile, for the visiting Ravens, they've come in on a nice run of recent form, 4 wins out of 5.
And if you look back to last week, it was all about their defense. Anytime you hold an NFL team to single digits, that's saying something.
Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. The former Oklahoma Sooner will be leading the charge in his 8th season now under center Sam Bradford.
And his stat line last week, that's not going to get him to the Pro Bowl. All right, no touchdowns, no interceptions, but they won. And so the bottom line for him is team won, managed the game effectively, led him to victory. He's doing all the right things.
On the carry, it's Cook. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Second down following the run. From the shotgun, it's Bradford. And he's got the hookup here. It's Kyle Rudolph. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Bradford finding Rudolph there for a Viking first. They'll run it now out of the gun. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. The starters now defensively for Baltimore.
Charles Suggs is a veteran pass rusher that still commands the respect of every offense that he goes against. Even though he hurt his Achilles in 2015 and lost that season, he bounced back in 2016 with 8 sacks, still showing the explosiveness that's marked his career.
Bradford hands to Cook on the draw. Some nifty running, but it only gets him to the 45. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a 3rd and about 4 more for a 1st. Now the Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on 3rd down.
Could be a blitzer.
Now Brad. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he's got the 1st down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. A gain of 3, second down. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Again, it's Murray. And oh, he spins past him and into space. Touchdown, Vikings. Latavius Murray, his first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead. You talk about explosion plays. Here's one pretty much right out of the gate.
And now they get to ride a wave of emotion, momentum, everything. Just as you described, right out of the gate, big sprint, touchdown. They're excited. But on the other side, they've got to guard against a major letdown because they hit them right in the gut with that one. And now you start to question yourself a little bit when you give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Kai Forbath on for the extra point. He's got it, and the Vikings take a 7-0 lead. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it culminates with a Latavius Murray touchdown run. Forbath out to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So here come the Ravens now, ready to get the football for the first time. And a glance here at the man calling the plays under center, their 6'4 quarterback. Here on first down. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Eric Kendricks coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. Partner, we had their game last week where they had 6 sacks, so a little bit more momentum here again in the first quarter.
And last week it appeared that they were coming out of sprinter's blocks, chasing the quarterback. So how do they continue that? How do they keep making it happen? Different looks, different disguises, different angles that they chase it.
They were so disruptive last week. We'll see what the trend is here as we go forward. Now a carry here for Terrence West. Yeah, nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on 3rd and long. Play fake. He'll look to throw. Catch made there by Brett Perriman. And he's able to get up here to the 26. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the 3rd down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up 4th down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3 and out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure they didn't give up much run after catch.
And from down in Miami, an update. The Jets out to an early lead over the Dolphins. Josh McCown, an early touchdown pass in that one.
I'm coming after you.
first and 10, Bradford. And complete, right side, the tight end Rudolph. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
That catch good for 5. It's third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give him a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for first down. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. Tyus Bowser from his outside linebacker spot. He gets him down here for a loss of 4. Before they can run another play, the clock hits triple zeros. And time is up on the first quarter. 7-0 is our score. We're back to Minneapolis in just a moment.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Vikings holding the football. But they face a second and long to start things out. Working out of the gun, Bradford finds an opening past the 40. Over the middle here to Rudolph. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 15 yards through the air and a first down. First down, Bradford. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's see, yeah, they'll spot it right in midfield at the 50. Second down, Cook. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. It's a loss of 4. Now third down. I'm no offensive mastermind, but of all the guys on the field to block, you might want to stop him.
Look, I've got a very simple rule. An unblocked defender is usually your best defender, and he ended up making the play there.
First down here at about the 40. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Cook getting the handoff for Bradford. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. Second down throw for Bradford. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Well, they try to swing it on left into the flat. Complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
The Vikings on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and nine. From the gun, Bradford. And he's got Kyle Rudolph. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right? Safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
Well, they don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Terrell Suggs in there to take him down and to take us to the two-minute warning. Coming up at halftime, remember, we'll get you out to Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of this first half. That is, of course, unless you decide to skip him.
And for the record, we do not encourage that.
On second down. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. This is turning into a bit of a death march here, the 13th play of this drive. Bradford now to throw on first down. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Michael Floyd, his first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead.
This has to be great for the psyche of this offense. Presented with bad field position, they didn't let it stop them. They rolled downfield and scored a touchdown.
Forbath to add the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And it's polished off by a Viking score. Forbath out to kick this one away. To return, here's Michael Campanaro. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. A reminder later tonight, a game some folks have had circled on their calendars since the schedule came out in April. That's the Super Bowl rematch. Falcons, Charles, at Foxborough to take on the Patriots.
Super Bowl 51 and a half, anyone?
Then on Monday night, that's no slouch either. An NFC East battle between the Redskins and the Eagles. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's got the hookup for the first time with a veteran, Jeremy Maclin. And a nice gain of 21 yards. First down now, but that clock rolling. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throw right side, taken in by Wallace. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. A gain of 6 there on first. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this belongs to the Vikings. A defensive-minded coach loves to bring the heat, brought the heat there, and it worked out.
And nowadays, all those defensive-minded coaches, for them, it's all about getting the football. I went into one facility, and as soon as you walked into the defensive room, there was a football, like on a spring, and each guy that walks in that plays has to act like he's knocking the ball free. They want those instincts created. They want them to think about that all the time. And that's what they're trying to preach.
And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. We're in the second quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, trying to get him more involved here on this drive, maybe. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. To throw again. Bradford. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Again, it's Bradford. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And the Vikings will use the second of their timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Throw again, Bradford, to the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. He'll get only 2 there, and it's second and goal.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. There's a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd run to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
They'll run for it with Cook. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. And Forbath will put this one through, and the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. It's a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they get the field goal near the end of the first half to expand that lead.
Yeah, that's got to feel good, but they can't let up. Now on the kickoff, they've got to make sure they don't give up a big return or big yardage to set up the other team for one last chance to score themselves.
And now running right through it. Now a hit and a loose football. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. He hits his target, left side, Watson. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Looking deep here for Macklin. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we've reached halftime here in Minnesota with the Vikings on top as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report.
All right, Brandon, back to you guys in a minute. But first, it's indeed time for our EA Sports halftime report. The Vikings are happy to be in front right now and just want to play two more solid quarters. The Ravens didn't play their best, and they'll need to be at their best now to come back. All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Vikings on second and seven. Murray's going to take it off the left edge, and nobody can stop him on this long touchdown. Now first and 10 as they take a 7-0 lead. Bradford's going to complete the pass, and he finds his mark for the score. That puts them on top by 14. First and 10. Macklin's going to haul in the pass, and he ends up at midfield before he stopped on the play. Ravens would later turn it over on a fumble.
Okay, Larry, a fairly one-sided first half as we get set to go in the second half. This is taken at the 3. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Minnesota defense, we watch them get set to roll. They don't want to change anything. They've got 0 points against them here, so I would imagine the halftime speech was do more of the same, right?
I think you're right, and it's where defensive coordinators have to walk that line of preparing for the adjustments you expect to come, but not taking away the aggressiveness you've already shown. And they've played so well, I think that's the speech. You nailed it. Just go out and do what you've been doing, and we'll adjust if we see anything different later.
To this point, they've been spectacular. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. On play action, they'll throw. Fighting to stay upright, but now he's swallowed up and taken down. Emerson Griffin in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year.
Partner, I know the ball security's preached like crazy, but every now and then, you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now, if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was 3rd and 10 versus 3rd and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
A play fake as they set up to throw. And he's got his man. That's Macklin. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They chalk that one up as a gain of 34 on third down. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It'll be a loss of a yard, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
Brandon, that play typifies what we've seen from the offense all day long. They've had no success getting things going. I think
the Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. Everson Griffin in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat.
Vikings try to block it. So much for pinning him really deep. Short punt could have pinned him inside the 10. Now great field position the other way.
It's never good when you're punting the ball and your eyes see the ball go back behind you.
No.
In however form, whether it's over your head or to the side, never good. Now it becomes a race to get to the football so they don't pick it up and take it all the way.
It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. Cook. And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Second down, Bradford. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line.
Now, that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
In search of something here after the sack. It's third and long. Bradford getting his guys ready. Here's Bradford. Well, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. C.J. Mosley in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up fourth and long.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first, this one from 40 yards out. And Forbath will put this one through, and the lead now increases to 20-0. So a good snap, good hold, and that one's right down the middle.
Never in doubt. Just the way you used to hit them, Brandon.
Forbath now to kick it away after the made field goal. This will be taken in at the 1. Uses the stiff arm. And the Ravens taking the field. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. The drive begins with a handoff to West. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They have been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
On the ground, it's West again. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22. Not the start to the drive they were looking for. That run doesn't do much at all.
No, not at all, and it leaves them with third and long. And you know, this is the time of game where these drives really, really start to matter. They've got to make some moves.
Let's go! 3-19!
He'll look to throw. And he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first. But at least it's fourth down. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
Meanwhile, over in Lambeau, an update. Now, you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Aaron Rodgers, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. On is the punter, Cook, who sends it away. Here's Sherrills. It'll go as a 50-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here's the Ravens defense as they head out to set up shop. And last time out, they gave up 3, but with this deficit, how important here is it to not give up any points?
And they're at a point now where they can't allow any thoughts of any points to enter their mind. They gave up 3 last time. That felt okay. They can't settle for okay now. They have to stop them here. 0 points given up.
Yeah, they need to stop, get the ball back to the offense. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
To the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA. Back now at beautiful new U.S. Bank Stadium. It's the Vikings in possession of the football and the lead. They'll be looking to add to that total as we begin quarter number 4. Off the play fake to Cook. Here's Bradford. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, it's a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. Meanwhile, over in Lambeau, an update. You saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Aaron Rodgers, a couple of touchdown passes thus far. Now Cook, and this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility? Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk-reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. Here's Ryan Quigley now. as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And he was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Finds his man, Watson, over the middle. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. That's good for a Raven first down, 15 yards there.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. He was trying to get it to Brett Perriman there, and that'll bring up second down.
Out routes are always timing routes, and if the timing's off just a little bit, it can really throw off a play. It looked like he let him a little too much there.
Yeah, there was a fraction of a second because he caught it, just couldn't stay in bounds. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. Sharif Floyd able to swap it from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of five.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
The Ravens on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and 15. They'll look to throw. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on.
Pass. Offense.
And they will elect to decline the penalty.
Everything turned out the way they wanted it to. No sense in even having to take that one, hence the decline.
They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. He's gonna float this one deep right side. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. John Harbaugh not afraid to go for it this time. Doesn't work out. And now possession's gonna go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Minnesota. Now, the previous drive they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well. They'll overall be happy with what they've seen.
On the ground, it's Cook. And he will force his way forward for a yard or two, but I have a good feeling this will be coming back.
Holding.
So on the big tight end, holding.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
Cook following the penalty. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 11 yards on the pickup, and they'll be facing a third and 12.
It looks like they caught him off guard on second and very long by running the putback. All right, we always talk about tendency breakers and counters and doing things opposite the grain, and that worked very well for him. Picked up really nice yardage, but they still have a lot of work to do on third down.
And a loss of three to bring up fourth.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in old days were often outside linebackers. They just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running backs quicker than ever before.
Around the NFL, they're in the fourth now in Green Bay. You saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Jordy Nelson, 95 yards receiving in that one. This is taken at the three. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. They are down big. They have not scored a single point. I don't know, are they so defeated at this point you just want to get in the locker room, get the heck out of here?
That is one way to approach it. Sometimes coaches say, that's it, okay? It hasn't worked all game. There's no sense in doing something now. Let's get out of here. No one gets hurt. But others will look at it and say, we still have an opportunity to do something.
Pride on the line.
Exactly. You have pride on the line, execution as you look forward and get ready for your next game, and a message to your team. We're not going to quit. No matter what, no matter what the battle is, we're going to finish this thing out.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the pressure gets to him again. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. That'll be caught. Wallace hauls it in. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Vikings, they have the football now in excellent field position. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down three scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
And the final play here will be Bradford going down to a knee. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is. What an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them? Going along with those zeros in the time column, too.
So for Minnesota, the win moves them up to 5-2 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Cleveland Browns. Meanwhile, for the Ravens, the loss drops them back to 4-3 so far. And they will be at home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Vikings as we say so long from Minneapolis.